If you think the Grim Reaper looks like this, think again. Behind the haunting hood is actually this guy, Florida attorney Daniel Ufelder.
He's dead.
The Santa Rosa Beach dad is donning this frightening costume for a good cause.
But I think it's too soon to draw thousands and millions of people to our beaches when we're in the middle of a global pandemic.
Yeah, I'm here today to try to make a point that we need to, I think it's premature that we open our beaches. I'm a huge proponent of public beaches, and I've been fighting for that for years. But I think that the danger of bringing all the people here to our area and spreading the virus, and I think it's going to prolong the recovery we have. And I think that we should take better measures. We're drawing people from all over the world to our beautiful beaches. It's too soon, and it's not appropriate.
New York State was right to put a 14-day mandatory quarantine in place. We need to make sure that quarantine becomes stronger every day, that law comes to life more every day. So starting today, we're going to do something new in New York City. We will have checkpoints at key entry points to the city. Travelers coming in from those states will be given information about the quarantine. They will be reminded that it is required, not optional. They'll be reminded that failure to quarantine is a violation of state law, and it comes with serious penalties. In fact, under certain circumstances, the fines can be as high as $10,000.
Well, there's something new at the fireplace, the Gentech coronavirus screening booth.
It's a game changer.
A booth you walk through that takes your temperature, tells you if your mask is on correctly, and then douses you in a chemical disinfectant. More on that in a second.
Well, I thought if I could take one more step to make some of the people that maybe aren't safe feel safe enough about coming out to my establishment, or any establishment for that matter yet, just one more step, that's all.
And how do we prevent this COVID from spreading?
The president of the Genesee County-based Genetech came up with the idea for the booth a couple of months ago. The orders are rolling in. He's even had to hire 30 more people.
We're going to grow Michigan, we're going to employ people, and we're going to sell this product all over the world.
Here at the fireplace, going through the Genetech is optional.
I think it's kind of cool. People are afraid to use it. We've gone through it many times.
Everybody appears okay with a temperature check and appropriate mask wearing. Things get a little prickly, though, when you got to walk through the mist.
They don't know what's coming out of the air purifier thing.
Yes, the air purifier thing. Actually, it's an aerosolized disinfectant. Now, science. HOCl, a.k.a. hypochlorous acid.
New tonight at 6, a Metro Corrections officer in Louisville is self-isolating at home after reporting to work with an elevated temperature. The officer was in direct contact with a COVID-19 patient while on the job last week. Court documents obtained by our Focus investigative team show something you've probably never seen before, an order of isolation. These have been issued to at least two people in Louisville who have tested positive for coronavirus but are refusing to stay in their homes. After the judge issues the order, the sheriff's department delivers it, and then Metro Corrections officers go inside the house and put an ankle monitor on that patient. This is the gear they've been given to wear while inside the home.
But there's like eight different people, five different cars. I'm like, what the heck's going on?
The police and the health department showed up at the door of that Kentucky couple. They were put under house arrest for refusing to sign self-quarantine documents. Elizabeth Lynn Scott got tested ahead of a trip to Michigan to visit her parents. She tested positive but was asymptomatic. Officials asked her to sign documents limiting her travel, but she refused. The couple says they never denied self-quarantining. They just didn't agree with the wording of the documents.
And that's exactly what the director of the public health department had told the judge, that I was refusing to self-quarantine because of this. And I'm like, that's not the case at all. I never said that.
The couple now has to wear ankle monitors, and if they get more than 200 feet from their home, authorities will be notified.